Months ago, they were a garbage team. But they're completely different now.
Don't sugarcoat it now, Charlie. Don't hold back.
No, they are very different. I agree with Ted. This is a very, very even matchup. It's really hard to say who's going to pull out ahead. I know EG's done a lot of preparation for this. Newbie should have well. And, you know, they're coming in. Neither of them have played each other before with these rosters. So it'll be really interesting to see.
Mm. For those that are new to Dota Gods, point out a couple of the key players on both sides, people to look out for.
I think with Newbie, Chuan is on the support role, big playmaker. He kind of feels that roaming, his lane being one of his key heroes, disruptor. He plays these supports which will find new kills, set the tempo. The other big player for me is Hao. Hao has just been the most aggressive carry player coming out of China, breaking that kind of stereotype of like the Chinese farmfest Dota. So those are two players for Newbie. 3G, what do you guys think?
Obviously, Sumail. I think the key for EG is you have to enable Sumail. During that period where they're losing a lot of games, is because they prioritized the safe lane. And you can't have him playing from behind. He's a guy that wants to be aggressive. He's one of the most mechanically skilled players in the game. Enable him, let him like initiate team to victory.
Yeah, okay, absolutely agree, 100%. He's like, you know, we talk about Miracle and Sumail. I think they're both the kind of players, you like Charlie says, you want to enable those guys and then you just follow them and just support them.
Yeah, okay, very quick predictions. We've got 15 seconds, Ted.
I think it's probably gonna go to three games, and I think EG can just edge it.
Okay, one word.
Slot.
EG 2-1.
Okay. Alright, we're time for the draft then for game number one in series number two.
Welcome back inside Key Arena, everybody. We're getting ready for our draft here. We have TI4 champions taking on TI5 champions in Newbie versus EG. I'm back now, and I got Draskel by my side. Excellent casting, sir. And we're back with Black and Winter once again. Draskel, since you're a newcomer here, I'll ask you the first question. With about 2 to 3 days of preparation for both of these teams, which do you think can utilize that time a bit better?
That's a tough one, actually. I mean, both teams, I think they have a bunch of very experienced players. I think that EG, personally for me, maybe they're better at adaptation just over time. I mean, look at the grand finals of last year and PPD's adjustments throughout the games against CDEC. So I feel like maybe EG a tiny bit better at preparation in this regard. But you can also see, like, banning the Disruptor, God was talking about it on the panel, just saying how good of a hero it is for Chuan and just understanding very well what Newbie wants to do.
And but we see EG here with their picks. Wisp, Batrider, Newbie, grab up Elder Titan, and Slardar. Now Black, last time I remember, a lot of people would say, and even EG themselves, they're not a big Wisp team, but here they're not afraid to grab it up in game one.
I mean, they weren't a Wisp team in the past because they didn't have a player that can play them like super nicely. But you have Zai, he's one of the best Wisps in the world, and he's recently rejoined EG. So it's definitely one of the strongest picks for them again.
Yep.
And Newbie just picks Slaughter and Elder Titan. Elder Titan obviously very strong against IO initiations, you can always turn it around. Slaughter goes really well with the natural order of Elder Titan as well.
So you see both teams here like opening their draft in very, very different manner. EG banned out the Disruptor because they wanted to go for the Relocate type of like global lineup with Relocate, and Newbie using Dire to their advantage, going for a minus armor strat on that side. And EG going to take out the Morphling, because it's very difficult for them to play this game where the enemy carry is very mobile and it's very difficult for you to catch them. Because you want them to spread out on the map and have heroes that are not that mobile like a Morphling when you're playing a Batrider plus Relocate.
Yeah. It's also kind of like, when you're playing against Elder Titan and Slardar, it's also automatically like hard to go late game against those heroes, because building like mass plus armor is going to be something that you're going to want to try to do.
I mean, in general, when you play against Elder Titan, it's always like the team that has Elder Titan, the carry of that team will always have the advantage, because the enemy team will always have to itemize at least 2 items against you, and in that case, Morphling is definitely one of the best heroes to do so.
Newbie in their second phase get rid of the Huskar and Ursa. This had been a popular pairing for EG during the group stage and found a lot of success. Fear in particular in that Ursa was a beast in the group stage. EG, you already mentioned, get rid of the Morph. Now look for their next ban. PPD had vocalized throughout the group stage and even on his own Twitter that he is not a big fan of the Naga, the Terrorblade, Alchemist kind of a gaming here. And even in their matchup against TNC, they used all their bans to make sure they didn't have to deal with any of it here. I haven't really acknowledged it too much. Is it something they could be at risk of dealing with in this particular game, or do you think Newbie have already drafted themselves in a different position?
Newbies
That's a good question. I mean, I guess anything is possible to a certain degree. But Nubia's opening is very ambiguous, I feel, as they can still do a lot of stuff with their lineup. Whereas EG, like Winter already said, they have a game plan already. They want to go for the pick and push. They have the IRB locate and the Pat Ryder to kind of start off fights. But for me, I'm more looking at Evil Geniuses, and I'm thinking, like, I look at this opening and all I can think is Storm for Sumail. Like, that's kind of another hero that I would want to try to pick up. Because, I mean, granted, you know, Nubia don't pick any much more disabled than they already have right now, and it's possible. But if you see, like, a Chuan Lion or something, maybe it's less likely.
I would really like a Storm pickup, actually, because both Storm and Bad Rider are really good against Slaughter, because Slaughter always wants to jump in, run back out, and jump in back again. If you actually have a Storm and a Bad Rider, you can completely negate that fact and just instantly kill him off. And for Nubi, I'm not sure why EG doesn't think they could possibly pick Naga, because Nubi is actually one of those teams that really like to run that safe lane Naga.
On Kaipi.
Yeah, he's just solo safe lane Naga, and then they just go aggro Tri-Lane and make sure the enemy carry doesn't farm as much. So definitely a threat from Nubi here.
Yeah, sometimes you might forget, like, against this team, Naga is being played by KP. They have sort of this adjustment where Hao does not play those kind of, like, split push hero. He only plays, like, the fighting carries.
Why do you think that is? Hao not good at microing, dare I say? Or just not his style?
Most of the Chinese, in my opinion, most of the Chinese carries are not as good as the Southeast Asian players at playing Naga. We've been playing the Naga hero so long, like, we are much more familiar and capable of executing the type of game that you wanna do.
How's your Naga game?
I don't play Naga.
Alright,
you play Naga.
I do not play Naga.
It is very true though. Like, you see Ice, his Naga is beast.
Amazing!
And probably the best Naga siren in the whole world is also from Southeast Asia, which is a miracle. Yeah.
Yep.
And like, just that region in general seems to have a lot of really good tinkers, a lot of good like Naga sirens, just those heroes that you really hate playing against.
Yeah.
Like, they're kind of the like country of heroes that you hate.
I like how you look at when you say that, like, they play heroes you just really hate.
But like the region, right, not the country.
I just hate you, you know.
Why do you hate me?
I'm not gonna play with you.
You will.
No.
I mean, at least Winter doesn't play those heroes, right?
I mean, they pick Winter.
Okay, they did actually.
Nice segue there, Black.
Nailed it.
EG pick up Winter Wyvern for their third pick. Nubi don't hesitate too long though in snagging up that Slark as a response.
It's really good. I mean, it's very good at hunting down heroes like Io, Batrider. It's obviously great against. You can break the lasso. You have night vision. It's just a really good overall counter pick. And right now, I'm kind of wondering what EG want to go for as a carry.
There's like a couple of options that I go against Slark.
I still think Storm is good, actually. Like, there's not a lot of disable between the Shadow Demon and the Slark. And normally, Storm matches up well against Slark.
But they don't have damage, though, if they go for Storm. I think right now, with Batrider, they might need more damage.
They would need to, like, go to back something like...
I like TA, I like TA more, maybe with the Bat. I can see the Storm still working for them if they have a very good laning phase. But TA might be a bit more reliable in terms of you get a lasso, you want to get a quick pick. With the relocate, like, they need to relocate someone with high burst, you eliminate the target and you get out. Because Slala is going to run you down.
Yeah, no, if they want to pick up Storm, they need to kind of go back to like TI5, where they ran like the Gyro Storm or like Lina Storm, stuff like that. They definitely need a bursty carry that is not very greedy if you really want to run that Storm. And also that Slark is going to have like a really, really good game. It's super hard to relocate gank him. It's like almost impossible.
Yeah. Like I say in the draft, when you're up against Io and Batrider, you want a carry that's extremely mobile, extremely hard to catch. They did ban out the Morphling, but unfortunately Slark is still in the pool. So a really, really good pickup for Slark.
Yeah, they do go for the Storm Spirit after all.
Wonderful call, by the way, you guys. So we are going to be in for a treat. The Sumail Storm Spirit is back on the main stage.
Legend. One of the best Storm players in the world.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Legend was made and during DAC. He was
The
Chinese people went crazy about him. It was like...
Who else can get beat down like 0 and 5 and then come back and just be godlike?
And have Bloodstorm in a 10? I was part of that, I got beaten down by him.
You were the terrible in that game.
I was the terrible
player.
But he terrorized me, man.
So now the missing piece of EG's puzzle is something for Fear, because you're going to have something that can man up against the Slark and bring in the extra damage for EG, so that's a tough test for him. And I'm curious even what newbie are going to consider banning. It's the Lifestealer, actually.
Yep, they have two good vehicles, relocate, so... Very, very straightforward ban for newbie there.
I wouldn't hate like a Sven, I guess, for EG. I think it matches up well. It's good for against the Elder Titan, the Slardar.
Yeah, I guess that's a really good pick there against those two heroes.
It's really good with Io as well.
The only issue I have with the Sven here is probably all their cores need a lot of farm. And it's gonna be up to like the Io and the Wyvern to create that amount of space and stack creeps for the Batrider. Because Storm and Sven will take a lot off the map, and Batrider, you're gonna need somewhere to get your blink.
But how do you feel like newbie in the early game, like they don't necessarily have the greatest catch? So maybe like needing a little bit more farm, at least for the first part of the game, is okay still?
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. They do have to worry about how they're gonna get their Slala towards his blink as well, so...
There it is. Sven. This is very, like, classic EG.
It really
classic
is.
EG when they had Zai the first time, and, like, I feel good if you're an EG fan for this draft right here, but newbie also have been kind of forcing EG to get that one last remaining pickup, like, where a lifesteal would have been perfect. They had to settle for a Sven. So we'll have to see if newbie are still going to hold an upper hand advantage. We're going for the last pick here, gentlemen.
Newbie needs, like, they need catch.
Stun? Do they need stun like DK?
Or what do they go for?
Okay. Yeah.
Wow. All right, they do need a stun like DK, so there it is. Final thoughts about the draft there, Draskal?
I'm kind of liking what EG are doing a bit more. I feel like it's total comfort zone. I think the Storm has a chance to do very well this game, and I think the Sven carry is really strong against newbie's lineup.
Black?
Yeah, EG's lineup is really well-rounded. I really like it, so I'm going for EG as well.
I think EG needs too much fun. I'm going to go for newbie.
All right, gentlemen, sounds great. We'll see how it goes down. TI4 versus TI5. Let's see how it breaks apart. It's going to be game number one in our casters for this one, Capitalist and Blitz.
That's right, as Coddle Guy alluded to, the international, the biggest prize that all the Dota teams search for has yet to be won twice by any team or any player. In this series, this is really where the race, the first to two, if you will, begins. Evil Geniuses facing up against newbie TI5 winners versus TI4 and even a TI2 winner in the face of Chuan match up against each other to keep their hopes alive in the winner's bracket. Despite such a storied history between these two teams, their exact strength and weaknesses in the bracket remain a bit of a mystery.
Yeah, especially since both teams haven't really played a lot coming into this. We saw EG a little bit at Star Ladder. Newbie's been almost a complete mystery. It's kind of hard to judge just based on the group play alone. Newbie looked kind of mediocre, but a lot of teams said that they were strong coming into this event. EG was kind of the opposite, where based off of Star Ladder, you could say that they looked a little bit shaky and they just haven't had a lot of time to gel. But since the group stages, this team has looked like a well-oiled machine.
So which version of these two teams will we see? Will we see the newbie that was dominating and being top three in every single one of the premier tournaments going into TI? Or will we see the evil geniuses that has risen up going into the group stage and has managed to get themselves into the winner's bracket? Now, we're going to start things off. Evil geniuses heading up to that top side, trying to secure Sumail. An easy battle rune. Newbie will control bottom. Looks like there's not going to be too much of a contest here. Our lanes should be fairly normal, right? Zai's going to be backing up Sumail, I presume, in the mid lane, trying to get that Storm Spirit the biggest jump possible. That's what you referred to earlier, right, in the previous series, how Draw Ranger matched with the Storm Spirit is what allows him to have a good laning phase. You need to be able to have that extra bit of health for a Storm.
Yeah, especially since Storm relies heavily on getting those first three items as fast as possible. Just the Bloodstone alone on this hero doesn't really make him threatening. It's really just the potential to zip across the map, pick somebody off with the Orchid, then just immediately get out. Getting that second defensive item post-Bloodstone is going to be really important in this game, especially if he's going to have any chance of surviving against some of these heroes. As I'd imagine a BKB or a Lincoln's is going to be what he goes for third. Even something like a Shiva's could really help him greatly against both the Slaughter and the Elder Titan.
Now, Zai had the idea here to be up in the top lane and stack up for the Batrider, that offlane camp. Unfortunately, to his dismay, he's going to discover that that one has just been blocked out by Chuan's counterboard laid out. So, no easy farm for Universe to be able to recover from. Meanwhile, newbie are actually running a much more active offlane of their own with KP and Kaka facing up against Fear and PPD, matching a 2v2.
Right now, it doesn't really look like Fear is going to get too much out of this lane. Both the Elder Titan and the Slaughter are such strong laners, especially in the early phase. PPD should just pull, try to get levels. Sort of abandoning trying to trade hits with these two heroes. They're not really going to take that much damage, and up at top, Zai trying to secure Universe's farm a little bit, trying to take advantage of the fact that Shadow Demon and Slark in the early phases aren't too strong.
Once again, Chuan, stymieing the plans of Evil Geniuses, manages to stop the pull over. Meanwhile, in the bottom lane, Kaka beginning to get aggressive. Zai has come in, will be tethered up to Fear to give him that extra bit of movement speed. The stun goes out, doesn't hit KP as well. The stomp by Kaka, is that going to be enough to be able to get him away? Stuns him all up, another right click comes out from PPD. Looks like Fear is going to have to throw out the Storm Hammer. One more second, he's got the mana now. Kaka goes for the deny on Roshan, but they're both stunned together. And Fear will cleave Kaka to death for the first blood.
That was the best possible scenario, as Roshan couldn't deny him as he was stunned up as well. Roshi even going to deny that range creep, and a very decent start for EG.
Absolutely. If you look at mid, Sumail's doing quite well for himself, 12-1, though he is out of mana now. do have the courier funneling in the dub bottles, though. So we're going to see Samael go right back up to full HP and full mana.
And this should be a relatively free matchup for Storm, as thrives against these melee heroes that can't really contest them or have kill potential against them. We're seeing that already as quite an early 15 CS at just 2 minutes into the game. Whereas Moo's struggling to break double digits right now.
Now, the Elder Titan, he had some impact in the bottom lane, but it also meant that he fed away first blood. The Storm Spirit's getting so much space in the mid lane. Is this where we start thinking about Nubi perhaps rotating both the Shadow Demon and the Elder Titan to try and gank up that Storm Spirit? Or is that just a little bit too much out of the realm of possibility?
I don't think you have to do that quite yet, because the good thing about DK is Storm has quite a hard time killing him once you get a few levels of that Dragon's Blood, which he already has two of. High armor heroes are something that Storm really dislikes. And I think Sumail's the type of player anyways that will try to prioritize farm in a game like this, because he should rightly believe that he's the best late game hero in this game.
In which case, probably better to try and secure Hal's farm, as he doesn't want to be left alone against a Batrider, at least not until he has his level 6. So Kaka will remain in the bottom lane with KP, trying to ensure this Lardar has a good start. This is much newbie through and through. They want to be able to enable KP to have a an early blink dagger on most of his offlane heroes and get his initiation in early.
Yeah, the Slaughter is going to be huge to countering the Storm. Like Winter talked about on the panel, it's one of the best ways to deal with that Storm Spirit, but if Storm just gets a little bit of farm, he can get his Bloodstone timing at a decent time, especially if before the Slaughter picks up blink dagger, he might just always have enough to survive even with the SD disruption.
Universe has been trying to bully Hal back as much as possible. He dove past the tier 1 tower as we saw and TP back for his Tranquil Boots, so he is off to a damn good start, a lot of that being helped out by Zai's Wisp. He's now going to be looking towards the mid lane. Both these heroes about to pick up their level 6. This is where potential kills could happen. Both these heroes are still rather tanky. Dragonite, of course, has that heavy amount of armor, and Samael, he's got that zip-zap. I don't really think they have the strong enough supports to really burst down a Storm Spirit off the Dragonite Dragontail.
They might, but at the same time, it's going to be a pretty heavy investment. They are making their way forward, trying to get Sumail before he hits level 6, but they might not be successful in that. And on top of that, Sumail already has a Magic Wand, one of the best investments to make defensively on a Storm, and he's going to pick up an Infused Raindrop on the way. So that should make it nearly impossible for him to die, but they are making the move forward.
They're going to put it to the test. They haven't had that 6 yet. Ooh. Just a little poke there, but not quite the follow-up in time from the supports. They may try again when Mu completes his level 6, but for now, they will head back up to the top lane. They also have to consider that not only all those defensive items you were talking about, Magic Wand, they even have Zai ready to go at any point with a tethered bottle, so making that attempted play at mid may turn against them quickly.
Yeah, they just wanted to try to get aggressive before Storm hits level 6. They were going to try to lead that into some tower damage early on mid. That's the best advantage of having a Dragon Knight in this matchup, is that then EG have to rotate maybe one of the two to have to deal with that. Then you free up this bottom lane. But as a result, Mu gets denied. Sumail's just going to continue to free farm. He's already almost up to 40 CS at under 6 minutes. Unbelievable for any mid hero, much less a Storm.
Absolutely. He seems to be not phased at all by that breathe fire damage reduction, as the extra hits from Overload granting him easy CS opportunities. Does this mean, do you think Evil Geniuses, they're getting the best out of the laning phase? Are you still okay with newbie still protecting Hal and not trying to put too much pressure on mid?
I think they have to protect Hal, because his early game is going to really determine how much real estate they can get.
Yeah.
Because the way that it works right now is that newbie, they have to take care of this dire jungle, and they need a hero that can kind of roam around this top area, which is going to be your Slark, to deny a lot of this from the farm.
A bit of pressure on Mu. They're going to be a whole lot more pressure soon, as BPD is going to wrap around with the rest of the supports coming in, as well as Universe. Mu is going to be the target here, but already the defensive supports of newbie are going to respond with extra TP. They manage to latch on a Universe with the pounce. He will be the first one down. The rest of Evil Geniuses retreat. In fact, they may even lose PPD. Looks like KP has his sights on the Winter Wyvern. Already has damn damage on him. No escape for PPD. That'll be a second Fear. Kill going their way, unless Fear can somehow stop it, but he realizes there is no way. And KP pops the mango, and Slithering Crush will seal the deal. 1-2 now to the favor of newbie.
KP already has 1,500 gold. At 7 short minutes into this game, he's had quite a successful offlane as a result of having Kaka pretty much camp this area for him, them contesting this Fen plus Winter Wyvern, but...
I mean, it feels like that was almost, in a way, a test from Evil Geniuses trying to go for a dive on the mid lane, because we've seen, more so than any other team, I would say, Newbie know how to play defensively around those early laning ganks. They always are set up with defensive supports behind their mid, and they usually are going to mass rotate to punish you.
You pointed that out before this game as well, that we are going to see this counter-aggressive play from Newbie. We got a taste of that there, as Universe not having nearly as good of a time as this Slardar is when it comes to his timings. Blink for him is going to be pretty delayed as a result of that mid attempt, but again, Sumail's going to be the hero to watch in this game. From a Storm player perspective, this is a very good timing for him right now, and the type of heroes that Yubi has, he can just eat them alive.
Which means it is going to be all the more critical for KP to finish up that Blink Dagger and get a successful gank on mid, coupled with Dragonite.
The thing about KP though is he's going to have his work cut out for him this game. He's going to almost always have to be the scouting force for this Slark. Tau alone just doesn't deal enough damage, especially with the Winter Wyvern, so...
Right.
KP is going to be in a situation where he might pick up that early Blink, but he always has to worry about falling behind in relative farm. If you only gank with the Slardar, you just get behind. You don't want to be in a position where at 25 minutes you only have a 4 staff and a Blink Dagger. You want to start building towards those core items and treating yourself like a third core.
Coming forward here with the Invis, he's gonna get a quick surprise initiation on the move, just a small pittance of damage, nothing life-threatening, but does force a rotation out of Newbie.
Curious to see what build Sumail decides to go for. Does have enough money for treads, but there is a lot to be said about going just straight for the Bloodstone this game and grabbing the Arcane Boost.
Newbie. Two supports sitting behind Mu. They have Hao with his level 7, actually level 8, about to be picked up. So they know he's going to be okay there. And KP, his lane is being pushed out. In fact, they're going to try and enable KP even more. An early invasion into the jungle. Classic Dota strategy at this point. We may see PPD picked out. It looks like they are going to be able to get the initiation on him with fresh Blink Dagger picked up by KP. All PPD could do is maybe get the Cold Embrace off, but not even that goes down. Upper kill going the way of Newbie, and they may be set up to push in that tier 1 tower. Evil Geniuses, though, pretty quick with the response. They're already pushing in the mid lane and forcing Kaka to defend.
You saw how far Fear was away from that attempt. I think G was kind of aware of that happening, but they were banking on allowing their Winter Wyvern to kind of soak up that gank for them. Newbie don't really transition that into anything, which is probably the bigger part here, is during that time period, you just had Storm farm, you had Batrider continue to farm, your Sven was getting the jungle as well, and Newbie, all they really get out of it is this level 5 Winter Wyvern, who hasn't had a lot of farm, has 628 net worth, they barely get anything out of that gank. Might have not even been really worth their time.
Let's talk about that philosophy a little bit. Our time together, you oftentimes encourage me to completely abandon that lane, don't even leave a support there for levels. While we've seen, you know, some teams do take that philosophy, others are willing to leave a support there and sort of tanks the gank in some way. It basically kind of sets up a situation where the team smoking and evading does get that extra little bit of gold and experience. What are your thoughts on it, and what do you think that really means Evil Geniuses' plans are for this game?
I think for EG, it's simply just, if the gank happens at that south side of the map, then you free up time and space for your Storm, because the Storm is the real hero of this game. If Winter Wyvern dies 10 times, they can still win this game just on the fact that this hero can get huge. Right now, he's progressing very nicely. He's already got 1,800 gold. This Batrider's not doing too bad either. Sven, who's going to really get ahead. All the pressure is on Newbie right now. EG can play proactively by moving around the map, but they don't have to force engagements, whereas Newbie, they have to, because you've got neutral things that EG can just take control of, like this aim cap right now. That Fear has already stacked 3 times into this game. Storm's just going to keep farming his jungle, so Newbie, every single time they show themselves as 3 and they pop the dragon form, that means you can't really make a move right after that. You're going to have to wait to cooldowns, you're going to have to wait to reset the map, and the Slardar. Look at his item build. He just went straight for the Blink Dagger. He's got no Tranquils or anything like that. He's going to struggle pretty heavily just constantly rotating. I mean, he delivered himself a Clarity, but he still only has 500 HP and AP. He's got his work cut out for him in a game like this.
So that kind of investment in ganking that bottom lane is essentially just a big distraction for Evil Geniuses to get more space. That dragon form being popped, the rotation, the smoke being used, it all means that Samael will feel comfortable pushing aggressively and getting that extra bit of farm. He may even see a rotation through the dire jungle and starts getting some extra golden experience out of that. Nubi already trying to keep as much damage off that tier 1 mid tower with the early rotation by Kaka. This obviously, that mid tower, pretty important for Dire side, right? It helps you control that Roshan pit, which is a possibility if Evil Geniuses win a good fight. More than likely, though, Nubi should be able to claim them.
I think the interesting part here is that what usually happens with this 10-minute play is you'll almost always see in any competitive game right now, Dire has any sort of pressure mid hero, they're going to make their way down into this Radiant jungle, get one ward down, maybe even behind the tower, a full commitment of that, and you simply just take down this bottom tower and you just own half of the map. But as a result of probably just being afraid of the storm farming, the Dragon Knight instead makes his rotation to this bottom rune, and I think he just wants to try to shut this down because he knows that Kaka is liable to be dived because he's a level 8 or he's a level 4 Elder Titan.
Yeah. Trying to make sure that Samael doesn't get the space required. So Nubi obviously then would have equal incentive to try and take down that mid tower. What do you think the game plan coming up in the next 10 minutes is for them?
I think for Nubi, it's continue to get aggressive across the map. What I'd really like to see them do is maybe even make a smoke play for this top lane, try to pick off the universe and transition that into allowing one of the two supports on Nubi to get some farm while Slark, once he grabs his Shadowblade, just roams around the map and creates a lot of space. Best thing that Slark does right now in this meta and why he's come back in such force is he just owns such a significant part of the map. There's no way that even a single support is willing to move around the map when you've got a Slark with a Shadowblade, and so they have to clump together, slow down their own timings, and you can't just always cover yourself with sentries.
Right. The investment. We are going to see our on pause finally. 10-minute mark comes through.
Or he does make his way bottom again. So that's what I was curious about, whether or not he would do this.
Change up their mind, they will go for that tier tower. Evil Genius is getting plenty out of it though. As we said, Samael making his way through the jungle, trying to get that extra bit of boost, and same goes with Fear. He cleared through the ancient stack. Obviously, Universe is having a decent time as well, trying to complete that run. So all three of Evil Geniuses are getting something out of this pressure from Nubi at the bottom lane, and the tier 1 tower isn't even going to fall immediately. They seem a bit scared with so many heroes of Evil Geniuses off map.
Yeah, but Nubi should just assume that there's a lot of farming going around. And if you look at EG's commitment to farm, you notice that Sumail's gone for the Arcane Boots build, which has kind of seen a resurgence. Or was always described as in mid.
There's the dive on mid.
Worried about
a level 5 Elder Titan isn't much to Samael, but with the extra TPs, they will be rubbed. And now the stun comes in from KP. They're going to go straight for Zai. He's got a relocate, but it's not going to be fast enough. He goes down and down into Son of Samael. Do they have the damage? No, not quite. The Slithering Crush. Half a second too late. KP had to be spamming that one out, but relying on cooldowns, they will not be able to get the big core of Evil Geniuses.
Very well done by Nubi though. They are utilizing this Blink Dagger on this Slardar very well. This is the kind of engagements that they need, but if you just look at the passive gold going on right now, EG still ahead on their two cores.
Yeah, you can say that mid setup where they're able to kill the Wisp, yeah, they save the Elder Titan, but it cost them their tier 1 tower at bottom lane that they were pushing earlier. PPD did manage to get the deny on that, so that was obviously gold exchange-wise not really going to be real good for Nubi. AP trying to set up again on the mid lane, but they can get another pick. When are we going to look towards Roshan and that Aegis?
I think even more important than the Roshan is for Nubi to try to control this ancient area. If they control this ancient area right now, I'd say that the pace of the game right now for them is very good, and they're satisfied, but as a result of this kind of going uncontested, it doesn't matter if EG lose one support hero. The cost of Sven just farming three ancient stacks and storm farming out the jungle, it means that your two cores are distributing farm very well.
Well, surely things are about to amp up as Nubi are completing that Shadowblade, playing it out to Hao now. Yep. And they're going to go for a four-man smoke, actually meeting Hao's lane. They're going to go
we just talked
that
about
ancient
this.
Stack.
They have to control this area.
Surely they won't be able to actually catch anyone farming that stack. They will be able to block it away. That was Moo.
They should transition, though. This top tower is worth it for them to go for in full force. But instead, they're going to go all the way around, it looks like. Don't want to get caught out. This is the smart move. Control this ancient area. We got two wards down in this section. Now they're going to know when stack happens.
Little geniuses, they kind of had two choices there. They could have actually pressured that mid-tier one tower or try and contest top lane. This four-man smoke looks like they didn't quite fully know that newbie was going to go for the tower, and they decide against contesting and just start setting up for the tier one mid, thinking that it's the higher objective.
Yeah, for EG, I think getting into team fights early on, unless you can start out with a numbers advantage, is going to be difficult. And you don't really want to slow down the
tower. Now it's done. Two-man slithering crush. That's going to set up Pals. Be able to get a Pals. Oh no! He got bounced back with a flame break. Misses the Pals because of it. And now won't be able to get the immediate damage onto Fear. So instead he turns to PPD. We'll be able to pop him out. Samael goes to the back.
Running out of mana.
Swan, he's getting low. We'll be able to make that last long jump into the river. But now he's right there with the amplified damage. And they don't even need a slithering crush there. They'll get a second one too. Perhaps Zai gets the tether away. But if he wants this pursuit. Get another two-man slithering crush. Zai with the amplified damage is fresh meat for newbie, as they're gonna claim the Batrider's life as well. Four down from evil geniuses, and newbie will push mid.
That was so well done by newbie, as they set that fight up perfectly. They had all the time in the world to flank from every single angle. Sumail just going a bit too hard for that shadow demon right there. He just did not have the damage with his build. And I was just about to say, they want to try to avoid fights when your storm is so close to his bloodstone. But instead, they're just gonna lose so many heroes on the back of that. On top of that, now their ancient stacks are slowed down.
The initiations from KP is really what set all that up. That two-man slithering crush, the miss pounce was unfortunate for newbie, but it didn't cost them much. Newbie, Samael, he committed towards that backline, didn't have the mana to be able to get it all the way across the river, and got stuck inside. Evil Geniuses looks like a game plan that was sort of cobbled together last second, as newbie find a successful initiation.
Yeah, they're gonna go back for this mid tower. They still have a lot of these ultimates up. The Winner's Curse is available to them, but they've gotta be careful. They can't take another consecutive fight like that, because Sumail, again, closing in on that Bloodstone. I think you wanna wait for it, but they're gonna smoke, try to secure this mid tower, and they've gotta be careful for this one. Newbie, I think they're itching to fight. Got all their spells available to them.
Maybe evil geniuses think they're gonna catch newbie off guard. This aggressive play, pre-blood
wrapping all the way around.
Newbie Arcan moves up. Here comes the full-on sandwich. They are gonna get a two-man stormbolt coming out from Fear with the claim. They'll take out both. Universe controlled up by the Golden Brace will be able to save his life long enough to be able to get the last out now on the move. Getting some extra damage onto Hal, trying to stay ahead of him. Hal gets out, but three down for newbie. Make it four. KP caught by the stormbolt. And now it's evil geniuses' turn to reap the rewards.
Unbelievable read by EGS Fear. Just assaults the support duo from newbie. They weren't able to get a single spell off. If they were able to slow him with the demonic purge, disrupt themselves, maybe they would have been able to win that fight. I think newbie was favored, but that was the perfect engagement from EG. They immediately take out the two supports. Can't write it better than that, as now Sumail gonna pick up that bloodstone and EG are gonna reset into a very good position.
I mean, if you look at the initiation of Evil Geniuses, the Storm Spirit, Batrider, Winter Wyvern, all these heroes are excellent at being able to set up teamfights for success, but newbie's biggest strength is these very disruptive, defensive-style supports in both the Shadow Demon and Elder Titan. Both of them have a way to kind of stall up your aggression, to put a pause on the game while that disruption or that stomp bides time and resets the fight for newbie. But when you're able to assault that back line like Fear did, take out both supports, as you said, before they cast a single spell. The fight looks rather easy for evil geniuses now. Set up for another team fight. 5-9, 17 minutes in. Evil genius.
Here has the blink dagger. Newbie's got to be careful, but I think that was pretty unbelievable. It looked like both the newbie supports weren't sure where the stonebolt was going to go, so they both froze. They stood right next to each other. They can't afford to do that, and I think they're going to prioritize the safety of them now, as Mu is going to frontline for them with that armlet. Very hard to take down, but EG, they've got the blink dagger on this fend and they want to utilize it.
Newbie going to make it as hard as possible for evil geniuses to find a successful initiation. Look at their positioning, hard right side of the map, sitting inside the trees, still not too grouped up where Stormbolt could catch multiple heroes. So evil geniuses, they're going to have their work cut out for them in order to get the initiation needed, and that's why they're actually going to back out. And this is actually fully tipped off by newbie. Great scan will see the retreat of evil geniuses and their rotation through the jungle and towards mid and top.
And EG didn't get really anything out of that. They cleared out their jungle, so if Newbie decided to make an aggressive move, find anything. Everybody from EG should make a full-on retreat. Should just continue to farm up these two camps as well on the two cores. Sumail can start establishing himself up in this camp as well. Newbie just want to continue to get aggressive with this Blink Dagger on the Slardar. Talked about how this hero, he might just turn into a fighter, not get enough farm, and slowly start to get behind, and trying to see that here.
B. Reaching that point. Right initiation, good turn this game for them, but it's actually going to be the Fear who finds the first stun out. KP responsive force. So they're in crunch down. Kaka gonna be saved in a moment by Chuan. A disruption will only buy a moment's respite though. And now it's going to be Evil Geniuses running over Newbie one by one. KP, he's gonna be next target while Universe pulling back Mu. KP, he'll definitely die. His Fear with the God Strength cleans him up, and PPD manages to survive against Howe's Assault. Tried to go for the backline just like Fear did, but wasn't nearly as successful.
I mean, this game plan from EG to consistently just go for the supports, pick up these free Bloodstone charges on Sumail, this is really what's going to enable them to scale, and I mean, the crowd senses it right now. EG is playing so well around their two cores.
Now Newbie going to have to go back to just farming away. As Mu pushing out that bottom lane, Hao going to take his part in top lane. Mu's got 2100 gold here. He already has the armlet. What is the next item for him? Because he needs more defensive style BKB.
He might even think of picking up a Blink Dagger of his own just because they lack some initiation right now on Newbie. I think Newbie is a team that desperately needs to start playing aggressively. That's two fights in a row now where just been found out very quickly, and he does go for the Blink Dagger like we noticed.
Call.
Yeah. KP though, like 270 gold right now in a position where he had something like a 9-minute Blink Dagger. This is not the kind of progression that you need to see, especially against a Storm who's scaling so fast.
But they need a successful fight, or at least a pickoff.
They need one fight into a Roshan right now for Newbie to get back into this game comfortably.
Genius is keeping themselves pretty well spread, feeling comfortable with their rate of farm so far. Yes, Arcelark is top of the net worth board, but not by much. Both the Sven and the Storm Spirit are just barely trailing it. Now looks like Newbie are going to find that initiation. They're going to jump on a Universe first. They don't quite have the burst damage, though. Zai's going to be able to come in with the tether, help save him, while KP is going to be jumped on by Sumail, easily taken out. Fear turns, fights out, move. Hal's coming in for the side, but once again, he's being distracted by PPD, and PPD jukes him right out. Now has to go for Fear instead, but Zai, he's causing problems, detailing up Fear, and Fear
Hal's not a bad. Now,
Hal's not going to be able to make it away from this one. Flight right back, and Zai survives. Quan down as well. Newbie lose four, and it's Evil Geniuses who will take the Roshan.
I guess that answers how good EG is. Three fights in a row now as they go for the relocate.
Oh, they want
the
fifth. They don't want Roshan. They're going to take all five. That's a wipe. Elder Titan down. Newbie goes straight for the tier one. They keep up the pace. They don't let Newbie have anything extra. And now the Blink Daggers start swarming in. Universe, he picks up his own. Let's see that one again. They tried to jump on Universe, but the burst damage just wasn't quite there. And Samael's initiation was so much stronger than the full force of Newbie.
That was so well done by both of EG's supports, constantly kiting. PPD alone, Tao occupied for so long, they were able to just isolate targets out. You notice that Sumail instantly jumps to that Slaughter, getting rid of that counter initiation. And EG played this fight so well, they were so self-aware of where all their teammates were at all times. Newbie, they cannot afford to take fights like that. That's a 20 Bloodstone charge Storm that almost has that Orchid, and he's going to render three of these heroes on Newbie's side completely useless.
Newbie, gotta be feeling a bit desperate now and unsure how to approach this. They keep on trying to get the right fights, and they find what seems to be a pretty good initiation each time, but seems to turn against Evil Geniuses as they just seem to have the right response in the form of both Sumail and PPD, the defensive and offensive sides.
I don't even know who you call the MVP so far in EG. All of their cores have been playing really well. The two supports occupied Newbie's cores for such a long period of time. Newbie just unable to chain together spells as a result of this Storm Spirit who's creating so much chaos in these fights. Quan and Kaka are just trying to keep up, seeing what they can do, but around the map is a little bit too fast for them right now. Is EG gonna go for smoke again? They want to go for team fight number four. Maybe they can even get a Roshan of themselves. which on the Storm Spirit would become pretty much untouchable.
Yeah, it's Orchid. This could be big. 20 Bloodstone charges. This could
be
the
final moment. They're going to be able to find Mu. Pull him back. KP couldn't get the stop. The Slithering Crush not there. Now the long jump in from Samael. Grabs Kaka. No defensive support play there. He gets stunned up, but Samael is going to receive some help from Zai. Start dipping around. Samael going to be fine. The Cold Embrace buys him a little bit of healing time, and Hao has to run himself away. But Samael, quick on the jump forward, is going to be able to save. Nice Winter's Curse out. Samael was a bit too far forward. Now they're going to be able to get the Orchid out. Hao, surely dead. Unable to be saved by anybody from newbie Chuan.
Oh, they're gonna go man alive,
but Samael, he just keeps on running in. The
Take
regeneration.
Notes.
He has so much mana to work with, and he just doesn't stop.
This is how you play a Storm Spirit. Samael's just giving a masterclass to the other two players so far in this main stage who have failed with it. This is the hero that made his name famous. He is doing it proud right now. Level 16 Storm, 23 Bloodstone charges. Like, this guy's pretty much unstoppable.
And he's already got 2k gold in the bank. You'll have that third item. You were really pumping that up. The third item for Storm Spirit is really where he truly comes online.
He's already kind of come online, and with the third item, Shiva's, Lincoln's, both of them have merit. He's going to go for either the Hex or the Lincoln's for himself. If he goes for the Lincoln's, I think newbie have almost no hope of stopping this guy.
I mean, look at newbie's items. They went for Echo Saber on the Slark. They went the Blink Dagger on the Dragonite. Slardar still has no progression past the Blink Dagger that he picked up rather early on in the game. These heroes committed pretty heavily towards being able to contest and even win Evil Geniuses in that 20-minute, 15-20-minute area. And it didn't work out for them. And now they're just not going to see the kind of mid to late game progression that they had ID'd.
And EG allowing newbie to filter into them. They know that newbie's desperate for a fight right now. Everything that newbie has done so far in terms of their build has itemized for the mid game. KP at one point had 200 gold about 5 minutes ago, now has 500, and they're in a position where they're just forced to smoke right now. They don't have a lot of options. They might even decide to go for the Roshan, but in that pit is waiting. There's a heartbeat there, but instead they're going to try to get aggressive. EG on the opposite side of the map, reading this movement perfectly, and newbie's gonna get denied once again.
Smoke not going to last long enough for them to be able to make the long journey up the top lane. Get close, and Hao might be able to scout them out with the Shadow Blade, but it seems like Evil Genius is going to stay pretty tight-knit here, excluding Universe, who will trail a bit farther behind.
Worst thing when you play a Storm is usually when there are two farm supports that you can't really do anything about that cover for each other, but
now
in this situation...
They found Amu all by himself up at the top rune! Godlike Samael!
Yeah, they cannot protect anybody right now. Newbie, they've got to go full retreat mode. Is EG going to filter in?
Jump forward, Samael, looking for more.
Kind of low on mana though, he's got to be careful. They're just gonna passively push out this top lane and dare newbie to fight them. Newbie just getting further and further behind us. They've got to split up the map.
Tier 2 tower will be taken by Evil Geniuses, and this will help Samael finish up his third item, which will be the Lincolns, to stop the Dragon Tail of the Dragon Knight, who kind of all in committed with that Blink Dagger to try and shut out the Storm Spirit as fast as possible. A rapid rotation though, and a long jump from Samael finds Tuan, a perfect pickoff with that Orchid. Makes it look too damn easy for Evil Geniuses.
No support can survive anymore. He can just make those random jumps, find heroes around the map, play this style against a Storm who farmed anyways. 25 Bloodstone charges. He just continues to rack him up. Even if he dies, he'll almost instantly be back in the fight. I can even bring him back. Just gonna take all these outer towers, and it's not even like EG have a standard push lineup. It's just that they're so much stronger. Newbie has seen no item progression on any of their cores. Slardar, he'd be lucky to get something like a 35-minute 4-step at this point.
Evil Geniuses, while they may be playing aggressive, they're not giving any openings to newbie. Relu K forward is going to bring Zai back into this fight, where they get the tier 2. Universe already scouting out that newbie are not going to contest this tier 2. Newbie pretty much have to hole up inside their base, it seems, as they really can't take a straight 5-on-5.
Problem for them, though, again, is their adaptation is to the fact that they kind of just have to go for these fights. not like their sword skill ultra well later into the game. Either of them can do anything against the storm trick. KT doesn't have the items to contest anymore. Problem is, there was a point where you could drop everything on Sumail and you could probably take him down and maybe you could kite the rest of the heroes. But now this is a Storm Spirit with 2000 HP, 17 armor, and a Lincoln's. There is almost no chance that newbie take him out, even if they isolate him 4-on-1.
Slark that would normally want to go Scotty, forced into an Amantis style position. Doesn't want to be caught out by that Orchid without Dark Pact already running in, so. An award going to be laid down. They are going to make the long jump into the secret shop. They've already got Kaka. Is going to be saved by the disruption, but instead, they'll take KP's life and leave Kaka for slightly later. Mu going to be chased away by Universe, and Chuan will be the third pickup. Triple kill. Sumail once more, running low on mana with the help of Fear. He can do it all the way into the tier 3 tower. Armlet toggling. Mu desperate to be able to get out of here, but not the case. An ultra kill for Sumail as he falls out of control.
And Hal simply can't do anything as EG. They're definitely going to chase this hero. They want a 5-man wipe as now he's gonna go for the TP. Sumail doesn't have anything left in the tank, but EG with so many team fights, one in a row, not a lot of hope for newbie.
Tier 2 being assaulted, the last one of its kind for newbie. And next stop, Evil Geniuses. Can they just in their hands and go high ground? Hell, this is great. You could even see Evil Geniuses perhaps push high ground without it. They are in such a dominant position at this point.
EG, out of all the teams remaining, they look like they're going to be the closest to maybe repeating as TI champs, as they look so on point right now. They're going to move into this Roche pit. Newbie, again, they probably just have to face check into this to stop it.
That gold lead only growing bigger and bigger. Newbie are not going to go for the Roche on this team. Start pushing their way out into the dire jungle. Maybe they're not aware that it's Roshan time. Maybe they just don't think they can contest. We'll opt to try and farm up what little they can. Meantime,
everybody right now on YouTube in terms of XP is just completely plateaued. If they keep running around this five, they can't really afford to show themselves as individual heroes to push out lanes because of the storm. Now almost has this Bloodthorn available to him. Solo pickoff potential for him is so huge, and at some point, newbie, they've got to come back and they've got to defend this. There's no opportunity for them to go for a split push as Gato Demon. A drop poison, but he doesn't want to get too close. Both support from newbie. They've got to be careful.
They think they're hard enough back, but there is no distance that Sumail will not go to. To pick a support off, he managed to grab Chuan Shadow Demon while Fear takes the tier 3 tower.
This has just been a miserable
there
game
it is.
For newbie. They're gonna call it pretty early, 25-9.
A Bloodthorn to finish things off. Sumail with 30 Bloodstone charges. The Storm Spirit is truly back in the meta on Evil Geniuses.
He just went completely unchecked, and out of all the teams that have run him so far in this tournament, he has made him look unbelievable.
Absolutely an electric performance by Sumail and the rest of Evil Geniuses. They look to simply outclass newbie in this game number one. Newbie going to